Remember yesterday the scenario was like we were talking about why we need a build tools for that. We need to automate certain tasks. We don't want to do by hand manually every time and get wasted our time on something which can be automated easily. And that was the build infrastructure, like compilation, creating a directories, deleting the directories, copying the sort of things, and then packaging and sort of all other things. And ANT is one of the build tools among many, which is helping us to do the certain task. How is going to help us? We're going to do so. Let's continue the installation. I'm not going to this time allow you guys to do that because I think everyone is well capable of installation procedures and all. It's very easy, though I'm going to explain you and sort of thing. So first thing, ANT, what is ANT? ANT is build tools, and I don't want to talk about more because you will going to visualize in another 30 minutes, okay? And it definitely is based on Java. It is a kind of, used to be a make files earlier before ANT. You can say this ANT, make, ANT is another build tools and like that, okay? Installation is very easy, okay? Hello. Okay, so installation is very easy. Just you have to download this Apache ANT package from here, and the latest is 1.9.6. You can download the zip folder, copy it to any directory whichever you want it, and mine is here, okay, and just set two variables. So anyways, one variable is a part of Java. So remember, ANT is based on Java, so it is dependent on Java. Java has to be there, JDK. So you need two variables, and the variable name is ANT underscore home is equal to this one and Java home, and that's all. You are good to use the Apache ANT. How can you verify whether Apache ANT has been installed or not? Go to the command prompt, type ANT space HEL, or just type ANT. Okay, it will, if it is not installed, it will show the error. If it is installed, it says build file does not exist. Okay, if you want to know the version of ANT, okay, then ANT, let me make it bigger so everyone can see it. Sorry, landscape is not going on. So if you want to know the version of ANT, then the version, and I have 1.9.5, I think it's the most latest one. Okay, so installation is done. Installation is as that easy. Next thing is what we want to use it, what we want to do is. So before that, let me talk about in that. ANT is Java based tool, but their scripting is done in XML file, okay? So it is a XML file basically. So whenever you have a file called build.xml, that means that is an ANT file, okay? You can have any other name as well, but I'm going to talk about first basic and then slowly get into advanced. So you have a build.xml, which is an XML file, XML supported elements, and in build.xml, you have four things, okay? Project element, property element, target element. Don't get confused, don't get worry about you're not able to get it. I'm going to soon. So you have a project element, property, targets, and task, and that is all about ANT. So if you if hard coded these words, project, property, target, and tasks, you will learn ANT within few hours, okay? So now I'm going to talk about each one of these, okay? So to start with Apache ANT program, you have to define the project properties. What you want to define here, if you look at my PPT, uh, Let me make it bigger. Yeah, so this is the project element, and you see this is very simple. This is a one-liner stuff. Okay, you have a project and the name of the project, a default I'm going to talk about, and base directory. Ish, as of now you take it only dot for all the time. Okay, so this is the project element, it has to be there. So whenever you start writing the script in hand, you have to add this line. This is the, and starting this, this is the start of it, this is the start of it, and this is the closing. That's all. So next thing is, first thing is I've done with the project. Next thing is the properties. Property, I mean, it by name itself you must be knowing, like property where we can define the variable and then value, variable and the value, multiple variables you can define with values. So whatever you want to use it. So property definition, this is how you define the property. Property, elements, name of the property is this one, value, it can be anything. As of now, the value is dot. Dot means current directory. Okay, so source directory is the value, current directory. Build directory, value is build directory. I mean, this is the property name, this is the value. Okay, so that is how you define a property. So you are done with the properties also. Okay, next thing is target. Okay, target and task is all about implementation of the things. If you define a target in a simplified word, it's a kind of block where we have a some snippet of the things we do it together, or maybe group, or maybe a block, maybe target. In ANT we call it target, okay, or in a simplified way you can say it's a group where you have a certain task grouped together. Okay, so what is target is equal to block is equal to group of what? Next question is, the target is kind of block or kind of group of what? Of tasks. Okay, you are getting my points? Okay, so this is the target. This is how you define the target. Target name is equal to dash dash dash, and you close the target. Again start the new target, and you close it, another target also, and here you have two targets. Here, two properties, one project, it can maximum have a one project, but multiple targets, and this is the tasks, MKDIR or JABEC. Task is just a small set of action item, action which has to be done. So something like this, in this task, MKDIR means create a directory, name of the directory should be built. The variable is defined here. So build, okay, here it's a Java source directory, destination directory. So here say compile the Java program, all the Java program underneath source directory, which is defined in the current directory, and destination directory, which is again in build. So that's all is ANT. That's all is ANT. Most of the things is running around it. So let me recap the stuff before getting into details. Apache ANT is a build tool. It's based on and developed in Java. Okay, you have if you're writing Apache ANT, you have to start with the build.xml. Okay, it is a XML based configuration file which does everything. Next thing is what? Next thing, if you're writing the ANT as XML, you have four elements: project, property, target, and tasks. It can have only maximum one project in one properties, one XML file. You can have multiple properties files. Target you can have multiple, and task you can multiple. What is target? Project and property I don't need to define because you can understand by naming itself. Target is a kind of block or group, but of what? Of tasks. So you can have multiple tasks in one target. Sorry. Like this. So I can create four times the directory. Here I'll create one, two, three, like that. So now you understood. You understood about the project, you understood about property, you understood about the target, but these tasks seems to be confusing, because how do I know what are the kind of possibilities of task I have it, and where is the example?
Yeah, Rajesh, one question over here.
Yeah, please go ahead.
So instead of having two targets, okay, mm-hmm. So can't I have one target and two tasks under them, like make the my mkdir and javac into same target?
Very well, very good question actually. Yes, you can have it. You can have all these tasks in one target also. But what will happen once you have a certain task? For example, you have a one, if you have a phages, you want to configure it in one target, you want to compile it one target, you want to create a deployments in one target, you want to create a packaging in one target. And sometimes what happens, you don't want all this target to be run in a one shot. You want only one thing to be done, right? So for example, if you want to run only the init and or only the compile, then you can do as of now. But if you add it all together, then everything has to be done in a one shot, right?
So it's like I'm categorizing, like I'm trying to categorize my logic.
Perfect, yeah, that's, you're trying to create a group together, so you can run those groups if you don't want all to run all.
Okay, and one more thing, this target name, init, compile, are they standard or I can give any other name?
You can give any other name, just like you need to refer that name. Name can be anything.
Okay, similar name for property, the name can be anything.
Name can be anything. Property is just like you name it, you define it yourself, use it, whatever, it's up to you.
Okay, fine, got it.
Okay, so we understood about the project, we understood the property, we understood the target and task. Next question is the task. Where I'm going to get, what are the capabilities Ant has it, what it can do, okay? How I'm going to learn the tasks, okay? Because by seeing this sample script, you can see this is a very simple script. What is doing? It is creating a directory as of now, build directory, and compiling the source code and putting in the build folder. That's all. But this is important, JavaC, MKDIR, because these are the tasks. Where I'm going to get the list of tasks? There's only one place I would suggest. I will not share any PPT or anything sort of thing, because every time it gets changed, and it's always good to refer this particular web page. If something got deleted, they'll remove from here. If something got added, they will add it here. So this is the list of tasks, what you have it, okay, in Apache Ant, which you can use it. See, these many tasks. Now you must be confused, like, okay, how do I need to go in each and every task and see that, what are their implementation? Yes, first time you should do that. First time you should do at least 1 minute on each task and try to read it, what is all about it. But next time you don't have to
click on JavaC.
So next time you don't have to do that, because until you have a requirement, then you won't try to find such tasks. So today we have, in this particular example, we have got MKDIR and JavaC. So let's do that MKDIR tasks. MKDIR. And you see MKDIR, it has all the explanation. It creates a directory if it is non-existent and sort of things. And this is the example. And this is what I have used. It's very easy to use. And it's very easy to use. That's the reason it is one of the opted tools for the building infrastructure. So if you want to create a directory using Ant, this is the only one elements you have to edit. Or like this. Word?
Yeah.
Next thing is JavaC. JavaC by name itself, you must be understanding JavaC we used to compile the source code. So JavaC, and here it has a description and hell lot of options you have it with the JavaC compiler. Examples, end of the page. Here. Okay, if you want to compile with something else, target something else, working with something else and so on, sort of things you can define. Hell lot of options is here, okay. Most of the times you hardly need these options, but once you are advanced and programmer, I mean a scripter, and you have a hell lot of complex environment you are working on, you might need it. So everything depends upon the requirement. You got the requirement, you got this attributes, and you can use it. Users is just like JavaC is a task which can compile the source of files from one folder and put it in another folder. Okay? So this is all about this. This is a glimpse of Apache. Any question before me going ahead further?
So in source folder we'll have dot Java file.
That's
and
correct.
In destination folder it will have dot what we say?
Class
I
file.
I don't know what is it. Dot class file. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, got it.
So Ant will create, because Ant is Java based, so Ant will automatically compile Ant tasks, Java tasks, and put it all the class files under the bay folder.
Okay.
Yeah, someone else was asking some other question.
Regarding the project and the property file, the project file is like for every branch or something, like we'll take it as one project, right, Rajesh?
Every Ant file has to be started with the project.
Okay.
It is just a project. Project means one file can have only one project maximum.
Okay. One file has only one project.
Okay, and project is nothing but like your project. It can be anything. In your project you can write 20 XML file also, and each file will contain only one project. So project is just to tell this is your set of activities as part of this particular project.
Okay.
And the property is like just we are declaring whatever will be in the target, we'll be declaring in the properties, right?
Whatever requirements you have it, whatever hard coding you are doing, you can define in a first few lines of that build.xml. So that way, if you want to change it, you can, instead of going through all hundreds of lines of places, you can change one places and it will be replicated everywhere.
Okay.
See,
just like a reference. Point of
just like a variable, any
variable.
Programming language.
Variable declaration area.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Ant is all about this one. It just, I told you, if you hard code yourself with a project, property, target and task, you are done with that. Task, anyways, you cannot by heart every task in your mind. It's completely depends on your requirement, what requirements you have. You come to this place, spend some time and learn about the task which is available or not. And even though if it is not available, I'm going to talk about the one other things also. So let's go one by one. Any other question?
No.
Cool. Okay. So next thing, same thing I did in this in PPT. I tried to elaborate each one of these things. You have a project which is important, which is not important sort of things. You may go ahead. I'll send you this PPT again. Same thing, whatever we discuss. You have a property. This is how you declare the property. Again, it's a target. We talked about the target here. Here you have a name, things like that. And this is the target again, the explanation of the JAVAC target. So I hope by this till here you must have understood. I don't have to read again same thing. It's in a, so I'm sure you must have understood, right? Next thing is a command line options. So every tool, it's not only with the and any tools, whatever you use, it has some inbuilt parameters or properties basically. Okay, and Ant has it also. So if you want to know the Ant stuff, just do Ant-help and it will display the list of options. This option is called command line options. Okay, so you can use it very frequently. So one thing, let's go one by one. Help, by name itself you can understand. What project help, it will give you it will give you the information about the build.xml file which has it. Version, it will tell you the Ant version. Diagnostic, quiet, verbose, debug and Emacs, these are nothing but a this file thing is nothing but a logging base, logging mechanism. Logging means what? So you run any script file and you get a hell lot of logs. Okay? How do you want to see that log? You want to see the less log, very common log, detail log and sort of things. So that is all about the logs. Okay? What are the levels of logs? Okay? If you want to store the log file in some specific file, you can use this. Okay? Logger and listener do not cover right now. It's hardly important as of now for you guys. okay, build file. So I told you just hard-coded ant with build.xml. But is that means you cannot use any other name apart from that build.xml? No, you can use it. You can use it any name you want it, but you have to add one more thing. So for running the ant script, you have to just type ant if your file is build.xml in the current directory. But if your file is something else, then you have to add this one. Build my name.xml. That way. Okay? And property. So there's one more. You don't have to define the property only in the file. You can define the property with the command line also. And this is the ways to define it. You can also call the properties file, which has a list of properties, and you can define. Okay? So that is all about the command line options. Okay? Now, before going further, I am going to do some examples so you can visualize. By now, we did only the talk. Now we should visualize the real stuff. So for us, I have created one sample project. Where is that? Here it is. Hello world, Java ant. So what I have done, it's a simple program and simple source file that is called hello world. I'm going to take it. So let me clear my screen. Protect pro. Underneath git, let me create another folder. Memkdir repos2. And I get into repos2. And this time I'm going to use cloning. So I just copy the repo. Git clone. Remember the clone? It is the co and config. Oops.
The repos2 and the repos1.
Oh, is it? Oops, I made a mistake. Yeah. I should not do that. Yeah, cool. Thanks for this. RM repos. I deleted that one. Get out of it. PWD. MKDIR repos. To CD repos. Clear my screen. LS. And now git clone. Copy, paste, and it's a public public repo, so I can clone it. Let me show you one by one. This is my folder which I cloned it. It has a build.xml and .git. You know, like every time whenever you clone repo or work on that, you have that got .git folder and source file. It has only simple file, one Java hello world program. Okay, it's not big deal, just hello world program. Okay, so let's look at this file. If you look at this file, starting with the project, I have only one property, okay, the value is source. So I have to change this property because my location is different this time. This is the difference. So my source is located somewhere in this folder. So I should change the properties to, I just change the properties. Yep. What I'm doing, I have four targets for that. Clean, create, compile, and package. It's a simple, typical workflow where we do certain activities. Like, first of all, we want to clean up the directory. So it should clean up before the building. Okay. Then we create the directory. So we created those directories. Okay. And then we compile it. And then we package it. So this is the flow. So what I am doing here, package means I'm using, see, for echoing, for displaying the message, I'm using echo tasks. So echo task. For deleting the files or directory, I'm using delete file or delete directory. This is the tasks. Okay. Next target is a create. Again, for displaying the message, I'm using echo task. For creating the directory, I'm using mkdir tasks. Again echo, and then compilation javac, and again echo. Then again echo mkdir for creating the directory, but packaging the jar file, I'm using jar tasks. Okay. If you want to refer it, please come. Here it is. Okay, it has a description and the so nutshell is create a jar file. Here is the example. Okay, so many examples. So this is a simple task. I am going to run it. Okay, so I have to run it using wizard file src. This is the place. I let me copy command line cd paste it dir. I'm into no d dir. I'm into this file. So I have an XML file, and I just said if the name of the file is build.xml, I don't have to write any file name, that and, and it is now doing. So as you can see, first target was clean, second target was create, third target was compile and package. Got it? And if you look at the here, it created a lib bin. If you look at my create task, I'm creating these two, bin src, and in packaging I've created one new folder lib, because I need a library file. So source file I was having with Java, I compiled the source file and put it in the bin.class file, and library I created a jar that is called apt.jar. It has only one file. See, hello cluster. Okay, so that way you can automate the entire build infrastructure using Apache Netter. And just what it takes, once you write the script like this, and just you run this and forget about it. You don't have to do anything else. Got it?
Can you show the build.xml again?
Yeah.
Okay, in this, for example, the target name create, okay?
Uh-huh.
So why we have created source directory again?
Okay, if you look at this, just a second, let me take it out, clean, compile. Okay, this is just extra line, it should not be there. Okay, if you see here, src, let's look at the log file. It's not creating any source file, it has skipped it, because that folder was already exist. So if you look at this,
okay.
If you look at the implementation of this task mkdir, it will create the file only if it is not existed. See here, non-existence. Okay, so I might have been doing some examples long time back, and just I might have added this command. Okay, this is not existence. Good observation.
Yeah,
any other question? No? Okay, next thing is, as I told you, I want to run only one target, and that should be create. So a space and space create, and it will do the same thing. Okay, but I did the create, but what has happened, if you look at the log file, let me show you again, this is called I wanted to cover this one. I run the only create, but it has run two targets. Why is that so? Why? Because in AND, this is called dependency management. Okay. So first thing, you look at this first line now. Default target is package. So whenever you run this program, AND default target will be build package. But again, package is dependent on compile. So it will, instead of doing this task, it will do first compile. But compile is again dependent on the create. So before compilation, it will first create the file. But create is also dependent dependent on clean. So before clean, it will do, before create, it will do the clean. So first this will be done, then second this will be done, then third this will be done, and this is fourth will be done. So that way you make sure that whatever the important targets is there has to be completed. So for the creating, cleaning is important because it, before creating, it has to clean first, right? Then the creating will make sense. So what is going to clean is clean.
And if we give only, yeah, right. And if we only give and at the command prompt, mm-hmm. so the default package will run.
Huh. Default target will run.
Ah, default target. Sorry.
Yeah. And default target is the final project.
In the project. Okay, got it.
Yeah. Okay, but like that. Yeah. So this is called dependencies management, target dependency. Okay. So everything, as I noticed, if you know the concept, basic concept of target, task, properties, and project, mm-hmm. you knowing the task is not a difficult task. Even I hardly, out of 300 tasks, I know only 30 to 40 tasks, most frequently used. Okay. Apart from that, if I need it, I come back here, this page, look for my task, and just get the example, read it, and then implement it. Because you cannot read, you cannot by heart remember each and everything.
So if you don't have anything okay. in that dependency in the target, Rajesh, like we, it won't go for the cleaning, right?
Yes. Let me remove it. Let me do that. I just remove this one, but it will display error, I think, just a second. Because that it's successful and it has skipped this one, making directory bin because it's already created. But if you want the failure to be done, then you can do so. There's one property. Let me go to that. Making directory. Just a second. Its example is not there, but I'm just searching based upon that my. Okay, so I don't know. Let me try it actually. Long before I tried this option, NKDI this one. Exact syntax I'm not able to recollect. And failure on, I think this one. Let me try this one. It is working. Yeah, this is working. Oh no, this issue is just this is the issue with the syntax, not with that. Okay, so as of now, make DIF does not support the fail on error. Okay, so when I was, when I was doing a lot of programming in ANT, that time this option was there, fail on error. So if the directory is already exist, it will, and you want to fail the build and due to that reason, you used to use it this one. But this is not there anymore. It's not supporting anymore. Okay, no problem. So this is all about the task. Any question, any understanding issues or something?
Nothing. So far good.
Okay, good. So next thing, we have a 20 more minutes and I wanted to cover a few things. Before that, let me give you one scenario to understand. I have missed something. Custom implementation, path, file set, class path. Okay, so these are the most frequently used tasks. You can remember by heart, like Java for compilation, running any application, Java, creating a documentation, Java doc, and JUnit, mkdir for creating a directory, copy for copy the file, move for moving the file, delete, file set for the any sets of files operation. These are the packaging, jar, var, zip, unjar, unvar, unzip. This is for displaying the message, this is for serious operation, this is for running the external programs, and this is calling from the another XML file, and this is calling from another target file in another XML. So these are the frequently used commands. Okay, just go through those and just make yourself aware. I'm just trying to scenario where I can talk about the dependencies, and this has to be understood properly. Packaging, enterprise bin, it's not there. Should be here. I had a few questions basically to make you help you to understand.
You shared yesterday's PPT with us?
I'll just forward you today.
Yeah. Okay. And of today also, da?
Yep, I'll send it to you.
Okay, Rajesh.
Yep, here it is. Okay, so this is the example I wanted to talk about primarily, because most of them things are same thing, target, playing with the tasks and all. And here, by seeing the sample, you tell me which one will run first. Okay, if I am calling, okay, let me see if I have something else. Okay, the first question, a target can be executed earlier when the target depends on it. So for example, if your default target is D, tell me which one will be executed. Just let me be specific to this question, just to understand whether you understood my stuff or not. Imran, you want to tell me if my default project target is D, which are the target will be executed? Tell me the flow.
Okay,
it can take few seconds.
Yeah,
few minutes.
I'm trying to read. So here, if my default target is D, correct?
Huh?
Your question was if the default target is D.
Yeah.
So first, it will try to run the target D, but the compiler sees it depends upon CBA. Okay. So it will go to C first, but we see that C depends upon B, B upon A. So A will be running first, okay, followed by B, C, and finally D.
Okay, so tell me just a second, let me note down. You told A will be first, and then?
A, B, C, D.
Okay. A D C D. A C A D.
No, A B B for Bombay.
C D. Okay. So you said if dependence is on D, then it will run this one. Okay. Let me see that. So if dependent on D, then D depends on the C. If you are having C, then C depends on the B and B depends on A. So first A will be done. Okay. And after that, the control will come to B. B is not at all, B is dependent on A. So A is already executed, so it will not be done. Okay. After that, it will be dependent on A. So A is dependent on nothing. So in this case, A, B, wait a second. First of all, C is dependent on B, B is dependent on B, B is A. After that, it's coming to C. So C, A, B, and C. And then last, B is already done. And A is already done, then it's last. Yeah, that's good. Okay. Next scenario for Imran.
Okay, one second over here, Rajesh.
Yeah.
1 second. So what is the meaning of depends is equal to C, comma B, comma A? What if they are given in...
So C multiple one here we talked about one dependencies clean, but it can be multiple also.
Yeah, but if you come back to the same thing, come back to CBA.
Which one?
Yeah, this one. Now suppose instead of for the last target may be if we just have depends is equal to C.
Huh.
Okay, then the sequence will be ABCD. Correct.
Huh.
Okay, but since you are given C comma B comma A, so what is the purpose of B and A?
Okay, so I'll tell you one thing. First of all, D is default, so it will first depends on the D is dependent on C. So it's tried to execute C target, but it found that it depends on the B. B again depends on the A. Then first of all, A is happening. And then B is happening. So first of all A and then B. And after that it's coming control and C is happening. Why C is happening? Because B is already done, so it cannot have a two times. So B and A will be irrelevant here.
Okay, got it.
Okay? Because once the task has been executed and will not execute again as per the same dependencies management.
Okay, so target can be executed only once.
Yes.
But if I have one more target which calls B and C again, so it won't be executed.
Yes.
Okay, got it. So it's okay. It's pointless to mention it again, correct?
No, CBA. It's not pointless. Sometime what happens, like suppose this, if I remove this scenario altogether, then we'll be having issues with the running A. Then A can be run. If you remove this one, then A will never exist in this picture. So instead of coming A here, it will go to D. It will get replaced with the last one.
Oh, yes.
Okay?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, so this scenario, let's talk about... If for Imran, if it is a dependence on C, can you tell me if my default target is C, which one will be executed?
So you're asking me again.
Oh, sorry. Madhu, please.
No, if it is like, if you are executing only on C, it runs A, B, C.
Okay. So if you're executing only C, then it should be A, and then B, and then C.
And then followed by.
Good. So this is called target management. So in a real-time scenario, you might have to write 30-40 targets and you have to set all this dependency mapping and sort of thing. So you have to worry about it, that one has. Okay. Next thing I'm talking about, that advanced ANT. So let's talk about it. So now you must have realized it by now, like ANT script is nothing but a collection of tasks which you use it to do our things as part of daily activities. Right? Hello?
Yeah, Rajesh, sorry. No, no.
Okay. Yeah. So by this time, everyone must have realized like the ant is of task. Have you thought about the possibilities? What if those tasks execute? It's, you know, for us, for the beginners and for the advanced level also, hell lot of tasks are there in whatever you can imagine. But sometime what happens, you get into some project and you have some difficult customized requirement which is not possible to create a generic tasks. So you have to, you know, work on that. So either you work on the different language and sort of things, or you can create your own tasks, and that is possible in ant. In ant, you can this is possible, like you can create your own tasks and you can use as part of library folder. So here is the Apache ant folder. You just add that jar file into this, add the class path in your build.xml, and you can use your own custom tasks. Okay, so but again you must be thinking, why the hell I should do the Java programming? I'm not the programmer. I've never done the programming since my so many years and sort of things. So again, you don't have to worry about it. There's a large community of the people who write their own custom tasks and contribute with the people out there. Okay, and that is called third party libraries. Okay, if you want to know the list of third party libraries which is already available, which might serve your purpose apart from these tasks, are here. This is the external tools and tasks which is available, more than 200 to 300 tasks available you have, which includes the how to use it, examples, how to install it. Installation is nothing but copying the jar file under the lib folder. Okay, and you have a hell lot of things. It completely depends upon your bandwidth. You have a time, you have a requirement, you just go to this page and make familiar with yourself. Hell lot of tools are available, whatever you cannot even imagine, this will exist. Okay, this is the one thing.
Can I download one of them? Can I download one of them and try to modify?
Yes, of course you can do that. Everything is free of cost.
They give us source code also?
Yes, everything is available free of cost.
Yeah, but source code also, so along with the source code.
You can,
oh, good.
Apache and let me tell you, if you don't like the Apache and some of the programs, you can download the Apache and source distribution, modify the code, and you can change the behavior altogether. We did the download binary distribution. Here you have a source distribution source. So you can entire reprogram whole Apache and as per your expectation. Getting my points? Hello?
Rajesh.
Hello?
Yeah, Rajesh.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Okay, so I was talking about something. Yeah, so here is the hell lot of tasks which is there available for you. But one of the most important tasks, and by this time you might have understood, you don't have any task which will talk about conditional statement or, you know, looping sort of things, because normally you do the scripting, you have a conditional statement and looping and sort of things where you can do the all this if and buts and sort of thing. But that is not available by default inbuilt in Apache. Okay, so for that we have one more task which was developed by someone, I don't know. That library is called ant contrib library. Okay, this is one of the external project which is one of the widely used across the globe for the third party libraries. Okay, this is called ant contrib task. In that task, you have all this, in this library, you have all this task which will help you, which has a collections of tasks which will help you to do the if, else, while, looping, mathematics related work and all sort of things. So here is the list of tasks. Ant callback, if, for loop, for each, okay, switches we have, you know. You can do mathematics related operations also, some task as I did long back. It should be here. Yeah, here it is. You know? And process system related things also you can do, the process tasks. Okay. Property tasks, platform tasks, this thing. So hell lot of tasks is there which is there available to you. What you have to do? It's very easy. just you download the lib file from here, copy to lib folder, and add these two lines of code, and you are good to start with using this. Okay, so it's all about the practices. The more you do the practice of writing Apache Ant and sort of things, it will be more helpful for you. Okay, so anyways, I'm going to create some task for you. So let me add some action item for myself. Send all the materials. Send assignment. Send forum info to post the question. I'll do that, this one, and sort of thing. Okay, so this is all about Apache Ant. You have to try, you have to, you know, read as much you can and then come up with the questions and things. One last task which I want to execute and which I want to cover is exec task. So remember, Apache Ant is built around Java, so it has an inbuilt support with the Java. But what if you want to execute another programs? For example, you're writing Apache Ant to compile the .NET program, or you are writing a program to compile a Ruby program, or you want to start the open command prompt or Notepad or MS Paint or any other application, third party application which is non-Java, then what are you going to do? So we have a task which is inbuilt task again. I wanted to specifically mention exec task, which is basically designed for external programs. Execute a system commands. System commands be anything. Okay, so here you have an executable command. This is the command line. It's external Java pro. It's external commands. You have a, so you're calling this command, then properties, you're running batch file through this, through this task. You have other examples also where you are calling this browser here now, and you're calling browser here. Here in this, you're calling the Linux command cat. So hell lot of commands you can execute through this command, exec task, which is very much useful. Okay. So any doubt around this?
No, nothing from my side. Like, most of the things are clear, not a problem.
Okay. Okay, so it is just like my job was to create a point holders, because there is no bandwidth as such. I should go ahead and run each task, to be honest, because each task it will running and trying the application, it will take 20 minutes at least to give you the show you the example, and my entire course will be over in the by that time. So what is the best way? I am creating a pointer in your mind, so that way you come, you know that what is Apache Ant right now, what are the capabilities it has it, and where to hit it. Okay, and the best way, I'm going to send you the today evening, I'm going to send you the some of the assignments, basically Apache Ant questions and then Git questions, and you're going to perform that assignment in next 5 days and come back with the results of the assignment, and then if you have still have some question, definitely I'll answer those questions. Okay.
Sure, Rajesh.
So before wrapping up the classes, let me tell you the next classes what we are going to cover. We are going to cover advanced Git. So please exercise these 5 days of whatever you as much you can, because you will have to ask some question if you want. And then fundamental of Maven in next Saturday. After that, I'm going to talk about the fundamental of SVN Sunday. Fundamental of MS Build. These are all technical training, so be yourself available. And then this starting with Chef, basic of Chef. So this is Sunday program. This is Saturday program. Okay,
I'm wondering whether SVN is required, because I haven't seen people using SVN. Like, all have shifted to either Git or some.
That's true. Yeah, but I will not be spending much time here. That's the reason I have added Chef here. Maybe 20 minutes. It's just like you should know what is all about that tool. Okay, and it's not hard to learn also. So if you know the Git, you can learn any SVN tools actually.
Okay.
Okay. So just I'll cover this 20 minutes or maybe this 30 minutes, and after that Chef, because Chef we have to spend a lot of time. Okay.
Okay. Okay, Raj.
Okay.
And would there be a session? Yeah. One last question. So would there be a session where we'll be connecting all these things to show the CD or CI?
Definitely, that is our whole purpose actually. That is the reason I explained you. First, like all this, whatever I talked about a lot of times, about this is the dots basically. Whatever we are doing here, these are the dots. We will collect third weeks. This is the second weeks, we'll cover this one. And after that third weeks, we'll connect, try to connect all the dots between all these tools. Okay? So if you do, as of now, you know the Git, you know the AND. So if I talk about, you know, build script, or you know, I talk about the cloning or in a remote repos sort of thing. So you know the technical words, right? So that way these dots can be connected easily. But if you don't know altogether the tool capability, then it's very difficult to connect the dots, right? Yeah, and in fact, Sunday, I think Jenkins basics will be there to cover the dots in the third mix. Yep. Yep. So let's wrap up the session with this. And any questions, I'm going to send you the forum link. Just pull that with that question and the error message. I'll reply within 24 hours. And let's connect tomorrow. I mean, next week, weekend, Saturday, same time.
Yes. Yeah. Yep. Thank you, Rajesh. Thanks for your time. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice evening. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, thank you, Rajesh. Bye. Yeah.